first audition, 10 a.m. tomorrow.
My first, if they'd taken me.
I'd take you any day.
How about lunch?
Oh, no, I've got to see the dance director.
Okay, then dinner or lunch tomorrow.
That's very kind of you, but I really must see the dance director.
I know a bundle of humanity. She's about so high. I'm nearly driven to insanity. When she passes by, she's a sunny little honey, but oh, so hard to kiss. I'll try to overcome her vanity, and then I'll tell her this.
Yeah, I'm so sorry.
I'm young and healthy, and you've got charms. It would really be a sin not to have you in my arms. I'm young and healthy, and so are you. When the moon is in the sky, tell me, what am I to do? If I could hate you, I keep away, but that ain't my nature. I'm full of vitamin A. Say, I have an idea. You'll never get Andy Lee to audition you unless he's got no choice. Come with me.
You better watch it. He's a tenor. He eats chorus girls for lunch.
You do know this song, don't you?
Well, yes, but...
Ah, then go to it, kid!
To what?
Your first notes on Broadway. What are you looking for?
My good luck scarf! I wore it when I was elected Miss Allentown, Miss Junior Allentown.
Come on, kid! Sing! I'm young and healthy, and you've got charms.
It would really be a sin not to have you in my arms. I'm young and healthy, and so are you. When the moon is in the sky, tell me, what am I to do? I give away, but that ain't my nature.
Who told you to sing?
It was my idea, Andy.
That's a pretty fresh idea. You beat
it. Oh, come on, give her a break, Andy. She's great.
Andy, Mr. Marsh is here. I got no time to wait. Mr. Marsh is here. And straight toots.
All right, I'm going.
All right, at least give me your name.
I am so sorry. Oh, excuse me. Mr. Marsh. Excuse me. I didn't see you. I am so sorry. I don't know what I was thinking.
What the hell was that?
She wanted to get into the line, boss.
Ours or Notre Dame's? All right, everybody, gather around and listen to me. Today we start work on a new show. You're gonna rehearse 4 weeks and try out in Atlantic City. You're gonna work 12 hours a day, 7 days a week. You're gonna dance till your feet fall off and you aren't able to stand up. But 5 weeks from now, Pretty Lady's gonna be the best damn show this town's ever seen. You're on your way to glory and $32 a week. So anybody who doesn't think you can take it, better quit right now. Nobody? Good. Now take a half hour to get measured for wigs and costumes, and then let's get to work.
All right, wigs in dressing room A and costumes downstairs. Well, come on, get a move on.
Hey, it must be hers, the kid that Andy threw out. Is there anything in it?
Yeah, 40 cents and a card. Peggy Sawyer, 125 Elm Street, Allentown, PA. Look, you go to your fitting and I'll see that she gets it. Julian, that was a great speech, and you won't regret a word of it. Pretty Lady is the best show we have ever written.
And that's why we're producing it ourselves.
And now with the greatest director on Broadway.
Never mind the soft soap, Maggie. I need the show as much as you do.
Wall Street got you, too.
You know the old saying, there's a horse's ass for every light on Broadway. I've given all I had to that glittering gulch out there, and it's been a hell of a ride. Okay, so the crash got me down for the count, but I'm still Julian Marsh, damn it. And Pretty Lady's gonna put me back on top. Let's talk about the cast.
Best in town, Billy Lawler for the juvenile.
Me and Maggie for the comedy roles.
And Dorothy Brock in the lead.
That's Brock I'm worried about. Her last hit was 10 years ago.
We have to use her, Julian. She's got Abner Dillon in her back pocket.
You know, Dillon's kitty car.
The kitty car business hasn't been hurt by the Depression.
And he's offered to put up the whole $100,000 if she's the star.
But she can't dance.
No, just put a lot
Here she comes. Dorothy, may I?
Don't say a word. I want to do this myself. Mr. Marsh, ever since I was a tiny little girl, I dreamed of the day that I might get to work with the King of Broadway. At last the day has come, and I am filled with pride, joy, and humility.
Thanks, Miss Brock. I'm feeling a little full myself. Now, before we go any further, I'd like to try you out on one of the numbers.
Now, hold on, Mr. Marsh. Now, Dorothy don't got to try out. She's already got her contract.
Mr. Dillon, what would I do without you? Of course, there were a few items you forgot to mention, so I wrote them in. Limousine, redecorated dressing room, private maid. No question about the salary, I just added another zero.
Now, see here, Dorothy,
Of course. If there's any objection, we won't insist. We'll just peddle our kitty cars and you can start selling apples.
You're not hearing me, Miss Brock. I'd like to try you out on one of the songs to see if you can handle the role.
You're asking me to audition, Mr. Marsh. I'm afraid the answer is no!
Oh, Dorothy, it's not an audition. See, Julian just wants to see if it's in the right key.
Try that new one we went over yesterday. Dorothy, you're going to love it. Now, Bert and I see you in this low-down dive. The piano pounds on a hot jazz beat as you enter and sing Shadows on the Wall.
Oscar, try it in three-quarter time for Miss Brock.
Wait a minute, Julie, we broke that
And down a tone. From the top, Miss Brock.
I'm sorry, Mr.
From the top, Miss Brock.
Shadows on the wall.
Mac, Annie.
Yeah, boss.
I want two shin busters. One right and one left. Miss Brock, right here, if you please. Hey, Frankie.
Yeah, boss.
See if you've got a drop on 28. Bring it in.
Coming in, Mr. Marsh.
Oscar, top of the chorus. Nice and easy. Kill the work lights. Miss Brock, if you please. That's all right. Look straight front.
To you, let me try a song that I can sing. Gotcha.
I've got you. Look behind you.
Ooh! To you, take me in your arms and let me cling to you. Let me linger long, let me live my song. Let me feel that I mean everything to you. Love's old song will be new. The shadows when I come and sing, in the shadows when I come and sing, in the shadows, in the shadows, in the shadows. Thank you. Wardrobe? How am I expected to dance with these sleeves halfway to the ground and feathers up my nose?
Hello, kid.
Pat, what are you doing here?
Had to see some booking agents in the neighborhood. Thought I'd drop by to see my best girl.
And what if Mr. Dillon had been here? Oh, Pat, it's too dangerous. Now be a dear and go catch a picture or something, and I'll meet you in my dressing room at 5.
Dorothy, I can't take your money. Listen, it was fine back in the old days when we had the vaudeville act. But now you're a star.
What difference does it make if we still care for each other? Oh, Pat, don't you think I hate meeting like this too? But isn't it better than not being ill?
Broadway facts of life. Oh, don't worry about me. Don't touch me! But now I realize that I could never
Come on, Andy. I want to clean up that last section before the pivot.
Correct. Oscar,
hit it. The last section before the pivot. So 5, 6, 7, 8. Cross, step, step. Cross, step, step, step. Kick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
What happened? One of the kids fainted during rehearsal. Par for the course of the Julian Marsh show. Give her some water, will you? And you better get back in there before the boss starts yelling for you.
When she comes to, let her know I'll be back as soon as I get my next break. The name's Lawler. Billy Lawler.
Yeah, come on, Billy.
You all right?
I guess I fainted.
Good guess.
Now, let me be your doctor for a minute. What you need is some rest.
But the rehearsal wasn't over!
Yes, it is, young lady. For you, anyway. Now, as your doctor, my first prescription is for you to sit up on this chaise. There we go. Now, as your doctor, my second prescription is for you to get these legs up. Come on.
And I bet I know what your third prescription is.
Darling, I wasn't expecting you until...
It's quite obvious you weren't expecting me, doctor.
Darling, she fainted. They just brought her in here until she came to her senses.
And since when is my dressing room an emergency ward for every clumsy Corey who throws a little fainting act? Now get her out of here before I prescribe some medication she won't like so much.
Please, Miss Brock,
shut up! And if my prescription upsets you, doctor, then you could just get out with her!
What the hell is going on in here? I'm trying to conduct a rehearsal on that stage. Who are you?
Oh, the name's Pat Denny, Mr. Marsh. I was a guest of Miss Brock's.
Well, beat it. Miss Brock's official gentleman friend happens to be in the house, and I don't want him getting any funny ideas.
Dobby!
Quick, it's out there behind the chaise.
Stay where you are! Come right in, Mr. Dillon. We were just having a little script conference.
Hello there, Sugar Plum. How about these posies for me?
Thank you!
Oh, I hope I wasn't interrupting anything.
Oh, no, not at all. We were just winding up. By the way, this is one of our dancers, Peggy Sawyer, and her boyfriend, Pat Denny.
Now, just a moment.
Say, Mr. Dillon, do you realize it's your fault this conference is breaking up?
My fault?
Dorothy said she didn't want to discuss the script any further because she wanted to be alone with you.
Oh, do you mean that, Dobby?
Of course I mean it. I mean, what girl wouldn't want to be alone with you? I mean, just look at yourself. Come on.
Mr. Denny. Your presence in this dressing room has caused a great deal of unnecessary turmoil, and I suggest such visits to not occur again. And Mr. Denny, this kid's a pretty good hoofer, and I don't want to lose her to the price of a bowl of chili. Take her out and get her something to eat. Miss Brock, may I please have a word with you?
About the character I'm playing.
About the character you're playing around with. Now, I don't know what went on in that dressing room, but pretty lady means far too much to me to let any gigolo stand in its way.
Aren't you a bit confused, Julian? You're the director of my show, not my personal life.
When your personal life gets in the way of my show, I direct that too.
I shall see whom I please when I please. And no show is going to stand in my way!
Bert, I think we got ourselves a little problem. I think I got myself a little solution. Nick Murphy, please.
Murphy? He's a killer! Julian, if you don't like the song, just say so.
I put a girlfriend of his in my last show, and he owes me a favor. Hello, Nick. Julian Marsh. I'm calling about a bit of a problem I'm having. You see, there's a fella been hanging around our rehearsals by the name of Pat Denning. I thought that since your place was right across the street, maybe you could send a couple boys over to persuade him to make himself scarce for the next few weeks. Right. Thank you, Nick. Pleasure doing business with you. And that, I believe, is the end of Pat Denning.
Julian, I just got a call from Atlantic City. They canceled our booking. But everything's all right. We picked up a wing at the Arch Street Theater in Philadelphia.
Oh, but all of our shows have opened in Atlantic City.
Yeah, maybe Philly will change the luck.
He's right.
Let's get back in. I'm grabbing my hat and coat.
I'm leaving the cat a note. Quick, call me a ferry boat getting out of town.
Sorry I didn't think any place fancy here, but the old pocket strings are a bit frayed out at the moment.
Hey, you know a guy named Pat Denning?
Well, yeah, we got a message for him. You better lay off that rock, Dave, or it'll be bad for him. You get it?
I get it. Yeah? Well, this is so you don't forget.
They were friends, with good advice. Hey, you with the company?
Yeah?
Well, I got a message from Miss Dorothy Brock. Tell her that Pat Denning is joining a stock company in Philadelphia for 6 months, with no boarding address.
I'm shining in my traveling shoes, big scoop in the Daily News. Who's saying his toodaloos, getting out of town.
Miss Brock, fella left it last night.
But Dorothy, why don't you want to go to Philadelphia?
Who says I don't want to go to Philadelphia? I want to go to Philadelphia. My contract says I must play out of town in Philadelphia.
Here's my mind and going by, and we're shouting.
So let's get moving. Say goodbye to little old New York.
My neighbors are all alive. They promise to pay the virus. Hey, I stand to meet your eyes getting out of town. Here's my mind, they're going by, and we're shouting hurrah. Wings spreading, cause we're heading for Hacha.
Costumes have arrived yet, and we'll be adding things as we go along, so don't let it throw you. Professor DeLugos, we're late. Let's go.
I know. Thank you.
Hoorah!
her beauty, not brains.
Old Father Time will never harm you if your charm still remains.
After you grow old, baby,
you don't have to be a
oh, yes,
it's your duty to be beautiful.
Oh, yes.
Keep
blackout?
I am suggesting you redo the dance to suit my talents.
That might make it a rather short number, Miss Brock.
You'll regret that remark, Mr. Marsh. You may be the director of this show, but I am driving the kiddie car. Get out of my way!
All right. The rest of you, you've earned it. So I want you to go out and relax and forget all about pretty lady till tomorrow. Then I want you to come back here and give the performance of your lives. Company dismissed.
Company dismissed.
Company dismissed.
Oh, Millie, I want everything on a hanger. Nothing on the floor, everything on a hanger, please.
We heard you the first time.
Willard, I'm gonna check those spot cues.
All right, Peggy, I'm gonna finish changing. I'll meet you outside the stage door.
I'll be there in a minute, Belly. Are you coming to the party tonight, Mr. Marsh?
Huh?
To the Regency Club. Miss Jones and Mr. Barry just invited everyone. Is something funny?
Here you are. Eyes shining like a kid at Christmas. Dreaming of parties and opening nights. The tinsel and glitter of musical comedy. Just look at yourself. A speck of dust on this stage. Indistinguishable from the 40 other specks of dust I put there.
I know that, Mr. Marsh. But put all those specks together and you have something alive and beautiful that can reach out to a thousand people we've never seen before.
Broadway dreams, Sawyer. We've all had them.
Well, I mean to hold on to mine, Mr. Marsh.
So did I. Sweet dreams, kid.
They are. I'm a speck of dust in your show.
Andy! Andy, where the hell are you?
I'm right here, boss. Coming. Got all those notes typed out. All 7 pages.
The notes can wait.
But boss,
I've just decided to take some of my own advice and forget about everything till tomorrow. Jones and Barry are throwing a party at the Regency Club. Come on, let's go dream a little. Kids who've been dancing their feet off to give you a show you could be proud of. Do you want to put them out on the street, too?
Oh, you wouldn't do that, Mr. Dillon, now, would you? Not after we put all our faith in you.
But she called me a whale.
Oh.
It's hope.
Oh, listen, in show business, that's a compliment. What you need is some fun. Why don't we go to a quiet corner, and I'll sing you the scores of my last six shows.
I don't care how many hotels you've tried. Try the Belvedere too, and now.
Julian, I don't know what was wrong with her. She was fine this afternoon.
I smell a rat turd, and that rat's initials are Pat Denny.
Hello, Belvedere. Have you a Pat Denny there?
You do. Well, give them to me, you idiot!
Hey, boss! Boss! It's Flo at the switchboard! She just told me Dorothy Brock's been calling all over town to get Pat Denning.
So I was right! Denning's in town!
Oh, Pat. Pat, darling. I tried to forget you, and it's no use. I've been such a fool. Please come back. I need you so.
What are we gonna do about Denning, boss?
Call Nick Murphy. I think he's got a couple of Philadelphia cousins who might be able to handle the situation.
Oh, Pat. Pat, darling, please forgive me.
Dorothy, will you just calm down and tell me what's wrong?
In a moment. Just hold me. Hold me and never let me go.
It's all set. Two of the boys will be over in 10 minutes, and they better not find Denning here.
Hey, Peggy, how about the next dance?
Sorry, Billy, but a friend of mine is in trouble.
A man friend or a lady friend?
A man, but...
I get it. Good night, Peggy.
Billy, Something the matter, Billy?
No, not anymore. Come on, let's have some fun.
Who is it?
Peggy Sawyer.
Oh, the fainting violet Mr. Denning took to dinner.
I've got to see Pat. Oh, Pat, there's gonna be trouble.
You're darn right there is, unless you get the hell out of here.
Wait a minute, Dorothy. What is it, Peggy?
Two men, friends of Murphy.
Don't you tell me to wait a minute. And what are you doing sticking up for her in the first place?
Listen, you just don't understand.
I think I understand all too well.
No, you don't.
Get out! The both of you!
But Miss
Brock! Wait a minute, Peggy. Dorothy, just hear me out.
I said the both of you.
All right. That's the way you want it.
That's the way I want it.
Dorothy, don't be a fool. Come on.
Get out! Out! Out!
Oh,
waiting for the kids to get into place, Mr. Marsh.
Well, here they are.
264, go!
Yeah.
out for the intermission buzzing, and that's the ball game.
Then we have nothing to worry about. The finale's the best number in the act.
Yes, there won't be a finale unless Brock gets out here. Dorothy, where the hell are you?
There's no need to shout, Julian. I can hear you.
All right, you're on in about 10 seconds.
I have never missed a cue before in my life. When I do, you can take me to task. Not until then.
Excuse me, Miss Brock. I just want to explain.
I don't want to hear any explanation from you.
But Miss Brock,
get away from me. The farther the better.
Quiet, quiet. You're on.
All right, 268. Go.
Attention, please. Miss Dorothy Brock has had an accident and will not be able to continue in tonight's performance of Pretty Lady. Ladies and gentlemen, your tickets will be refunded at the box office. House lights!
My decision is final.
final. No star, no show. Tell the kids to clear out of their dressing rooms. Pretty lady closes tonight.
The show is closing.
I'm out of a job.
I can't pay my rent.
What am I gonna do?
The show is closing.
Sing, tra la 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 la. The sun may never ever shine,
but tra la.
Julie, it's worth a try, isn't it?
You just fired her.
Oh, what? It may not be too late to get her back. She's taking the 1110 to Allentown. That gives you 20 minutes to get down to Broad Street Station.
What do we do, boss? Get her off that train. I'm on Sawyer in New York ready to work at 8 o'clock tomorrow morning.
But ain't he going to stay here in Philadelphia?
And lose $10,000 a night? Our only chance is to ship the show to New York, feed the party tour in 36 hours, and open cold on Thursday. Now get going! No, wait a minute! This is my job. I fired her. It's up to me to get her back.
Julian, I'm the producer.
I said I'll go. Thank you, Annie. You may have done me quite a favor.
Anytime, Mr. Marsh. Anytime! All right! We'll give them 15 minutes to convince her, and then we'll bring out the big gun!
You did me a favor, Mr. Marsh. It may not have been easy, but I got the message loud and clear. Go back to where you came from, Miss Peggy Sawyer, and that's just what I'm gonna do.
Sawyer, I've come here to apologize and to ask you to come back.
I have a train to catch, Mr. Marsh.
And to take over Dorothy Brock's role in Pretty Lady. Her ankle's broken. She's out of the show. If you can do it, the part's yours.
I'm sorry, Mr. Marsh. Show business isn't for me. I'm going back to Allentown.
What was that word you just said? Allentown? I'm offering you the chance to star in the biggest musical Broadway scene in 20 years, and you say Allentown? Now listen, Sawyer, and listen good. Even if you don't give a damn about me, think all those kids you'll be throwing out of work if you don't do this. Think of the songs that will wither and die if you don't get up there and sing them. Think of the scenery that'll never be seen, the costumes never worn, the orchestrations never heard. Think of Pretty Lady and the thrill and pleasure it could give to millions. Think of musical comedy, the most glorious words in the English language. Sawyer, think of Broadway, damn it. Come on along and listen to the lullaby of Broadway. The hip hooray and ballyhoos, the lullaby of Broadway. The rumble of a subway train, the rattle of the taxis, the daffodils.
Listen to the lullaby of Broadway.
The honey, high, and from deep.
minutes late.
I'm sorry, Mr. Marsh. I was looking for my good luck scarf.
Sawyer, Pretty Lady opens on this stage in exactly 36 hours. You've got 25 pages, 6 songs, and 10 dance routines to learn by 8:30 tomorrow night. Do you think you can do it? Do you think you can do it, Sawyer?
Yes, Mr. Marsh, I can.
Good. Then we begin. Oscar, Mac, where the hell's the piano?
Coming in, Mr. Marsh.
Andy, let's go. Now, I want to start with the opening number, then work through the songs and dances, then go back and do the scenes. There'll be a 5-minute break every hour for food or coffee, and a full 15 minutes every 4 hours for rest. And no one else on this stage until I call them.
All right, clear the stage!
Clear the stage!
By tomorrow night, I'll either have a live leading lady or a dead chorus girl. Well, what are you waiting for? Let's go!
All right.
Peggy steps on the right foot. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yes, now. Smile on, pal. You're on the back row now. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'll pick him up. Pick him up. 6:30, Sawyer. That curtain goes up in exactly 2 hours. It's now or never. Take it from Jim's entrance. Well, what are you waiting for from Jim's entrance?
Jim, they didn't tell me you were here. It was grand of you to come.
No, that's impossible. You're greeting the man you love. Make it mean something. Like this. Jim. They didn't tell me you were here.
It was grand of you to come.
Try it again.
Jim! They didn't tell me you were here. It was grand of you to come.
No, it won't do. Look, have you ever been in love before? Have you ever had a man take you in his arms and crush you to him and kiss you? Now say the lines.
Jim, they didn't tell me you were here. It's made you
again.
Jim. It was grand of you to come.
One,
up in 45 minutes. Unless she knows this part way down in her gut, she'll never get through. And that goes for the rest of you, too. Andy, take him down to the lounge and clean up those last 16 bars.
All right. Everybody get down to the lounge.
Come on, get a move on.
Show you what I mean? I would appreciate it very much, Dorothy.
I'm
best. I want sheer, unadulterated brilliance. And what are you girls hanging around for? Getting your places for the opening. Peggy, I want to talk to you.
Julian, it's 8:40. We've got to call places.
They waited this long. They can wait another minute. Now listen, and listen hard. 100 people. 100 jobs. $100,000. 5 weeks of grind and blood and sweat. And it all depends on what you do out there tonight. Oh, I know what you're thinking. Here comes Marsh with another one of his pep talks. Well, this is the last of them, Sawyer. And it comes straight from the heart. Our hopes, our futures, our lives are in your hands. Go out there and make them shine with your golden talent. This afternoon, there was acting. This one, I mean.
Julian, we've got to begin!
All right, tell him to take the house to half. Sawyer, you're going out there a youngster, but you've got to come back a star!
Money brings just a little filthy lucre.
finished yet. The toughest part is coming. You gotta give more in the finale, so dig down in deep, Sawyer, and pull it out. You're gonna need it. Now go get changed.
We're ready for the wedding section, Mr. Marsh.
Well, what are you waiting for?
223, go!
Honeymoon in store is one that you'll adore. I'm gonna take you for a ride.
You go home and get your panties, I'll go home and get my panties, and away we'll go.
Honeymoon that's cheaper and the train goes slow.
Ooh, off we're gonna shuffle, shuffle off to Buffalo.
Someday the stork may pay a visit and leave a little souvenir. Just a little cute, what is it? But we'll discuss that later, dear.
For a little silver quarter, we can have the Pullman order, turn the lights down low.
Ooh, off we're gonna shuffle, shuffle off to Buffalo. Thank you.
without that thing either. I'm Julian Marsh, dammit, and I say you will.
double for me. Now, come on. Let's go to the kids' party at Lorraine.
Gee, Billy, I'm not sure I can. What about the party at the Ritz? Oh. Billy, am I really a star?
From now on and forever.
And stars can do anything they want?
Anything.
Then I want to go to the kids' party.
Peggy!
Billy, wait a minute.
You haven't changed your mind, have you?
Of course not. I'll be along in a minute. Wait for me at the stage door.
All right, but just 1 minute. You know how impatient us tenors are.
Mr. Marsh?
Peggy. Say, what is the matter with me? In all the excitement, I forgot to congratulate you. Congratulations, kid.
Thank you, Mr. Marsh. But you and I both know who was really out on that stage tonight. Oh, I said all the lines, did the steps, and sang the songs. But you were inside me pulling the strings. So, I congratulate you.
You're quite a girl, Miss Peggy Sawyer. Quite a girl. And you're on your way to becoming quite a star. You've broken through, Peggy. You're the million to one shot who comes home a winner. For years to come, thousands of little chorus girls will go to auditions and say to themselves, who knows, maybe I'll come out of this one another Peggy Sawyer. I ask you only to be the sort of star those little girls would want you to be. Shine your light over this glorious gulch they call 42nd Street. Give it your strength, your talent, your youth. But try, if you can, not to give it all your heart, because it's a very loving heart, and I would never want to see it broken. Now, run along to the Ritz and enjoy yourself.
I'm going to the kids' party.
I was right. You're quite a girl.
Good night, Mr. Marsh.
Good night, Allentown. Where is the kids' party?
Oh, Lorraine! The address is on the call board. And Mr. Marsh. It would be grand, grand, grand! If you would come.
Andy.
Good night, Mr. Marsh.
Good night, Matt.
On the avenue I
Thank you.